Hey, Sunday, what's up? 9:30. Let's go. We got a half an hour, maybe half an hour, maybe 25 minutes. Workout. We all can do it. Body weight. You don't need any equipment. Jump on here. If you have kids, amazing. Get them to work out with you. If you don't have kids, whatever. Let's get going. Okay? We have a lot of single-legged stuff today. So, when you're ready, we're going to get going. It might rain, so this could be a bust. I really hope it's not. I hope we can get that half an hour in. Let's get moving so we can beat this rain. All right, test retest today, overhead reach. So when you're ready, I'm going to stand sideways to show you what I don't want. I don't want this to get your hands up overhead. Lock your ribs down, keep that back nice and neutral. Nice big reach up. You can look forward. So you can see this way, my elbows are super bent. It feels super sticky up in my shoulders and my neck. Okay, that's all you gotta do. Notice where you feel things. Maybe how you look if you have a mirror or a window nearby, if your elbows are like this as well. We're not moving too well yet, okay? So first one, child's pose, please, when you're ready. Knees can be wider than your hips. I'm gonna have my toes tucked. Just slide your bum back to your heels. Reach forward with your fingertips. Take a nice big breath. You want your back to move with your breath here. As you exhale, let it go. Inhale, pull yourself forward. Drop your hips down to the floor. You're gonna do maybe a shoulder check each side. That might feel nice. Big exhale, pull your bum back. We're gonna do that three times, so two more times. Big inhale. Exhale, reach your butt and your fingers away from each other. Next inhale, pull it forward. Drop your hips. Shoulder check, shoulder check. All right, one more. Awesome. After that third one, push your hips back. We're going to come into hands and knees, quadruped. Disco, a little dance move, okay? So left hand right underneath your shoulder. We're gonna take your right hand behind your ear. Now as you exhale, you want to lift your elbow up towards the sky without moving your hips too much. So as soon as I drop into my hips, I can open up more. Inhale, elbow to wrist. Exhale, open up. Don't let those hips move. Whew, rotation through mid-back. Feels sticky for me, guys. Let's do five of these. There's three. Four, five, dance on the other side. Left hand behind your ear. Inhale, elbow down, exhale, elbow up. Five of these, guys. Be aware of where your hips are in space. Again, don't let them shift or open up. We want this movement through your mid-back. There's four. Awesome, hands come down, kick those toes back. We're gonna go three rounds, greatest stretch per side. Right foot outside of right hand. Reach that right hand up to the sky, nice big breath. You can sit into that right hip if you'd like. Left side, sit into your left hip. Big breath, two more per side. So if you're just jumping on, I mentioned that it might rain. I really hope it's not. My car said 11 degrees when I was driving up here today. Feels like fall again. So, this could be a bust in a couple minutes, but I really hope it's not gonna rain. I don't think it will. Just warning you. There we go, there's number three on the left. Last but not least, we're gonna come flat to our belly. Chest open, okay, so you can cactus the arms or reach the arms out. Gonna look to my right hand, bend my right knee, lift it up and over to the left. That opening through the left chest, left shoulder. And it'll feel different if your elbow is bent or your arm is straight. Okay, it changes the muscles that is stretching there. So if you don't feel too much with your arm out, maybe bend your elbow. And we're breathing. We're gonna go three per side here too. There's number two on the left. Big breath. Number three. We are gonna retest, of course. So if you're with me, if you're moving with me, this is the last one on the right-hand side. Number three, big breath. And then we gotta retest. Please let me know if you feel better. Okay, so our test was an overhead reach. We gotta retest your overhead reach. Again, you don't wanna go here to get your arms up overhead. Lock your ribs down. Keep that back nice and neutral. Reach your hands up. All right, if you were here with me when I did this the first time, my elbows were about there. So I got some more space. You can do it another time if you want. If you feel better, please let me know. Let me know. And then we're gonna get rolling. We gotta do our rolls. We gotta prep that core. Kids, if you're joining, rolling, super important. Adults, you're joining, rolling is super important. It's the first movement that we do as a baby. First thing, can't roll, can't move too well, or maybe you don't feel good moving. Okay, do you guys feel good? Do you feel better? Overhead reach, how we doing? Anybody out there? Let me know. I'm giving myself a thumbs up. Quiet Sunday out here, you guys. Okay. Rolling patterns. We're gonna do upper body rolls, two to the right, two to the left. If your head does not move or your eyes don't follow your hand, you're not gonna move or roll too well. Thank you, Sarah. So glad you're feeling better. Thank you. So if you're trying to roll and your back of your head's on the ground, it's gonna be really hard. So as you reach your hand, lift your head, your eyes follow your hand, please, okay? I'm gonna move some stuff out of the way. Two to the right, two to the left. I'm gonna face the other way so you guys can see my upper body. So right hand up to the sky. We're gonna reach as far as we can to the left. Again, if our head doesn't lift up off the ground, you're not gonna roll too well. So as your fingers reach, your eyes, your head follow. Reach. Not allowed to use your legs. And you flop all the way to your tummy. To go back, your hand has to reach first. Eyes follow. And you roll back to your back. So lower body, not allowed to use. Don't cheat. Hand reaches, head lifts. Smell that left armpit. There you go. Get back onto your back. Your hand leads. There's two to the right. Two with the left hand. So again, remember if you're reaching, your head's not lifting, look how hard it is for me. Right hand reaches, head lifts. My left side's always harder than my right. There we go. Hand reaches, hand leads. There we go, number one. One more to the left. Reach. Woo! Some stuff in the way. All right, one more to your back. Woo, there we go. They're really weird when you first start rolling patterns, but then once you get it, okay? Half kneeling, please. My left knee is down, right foot is out in front. It's right underneath my right knee, so I'm not reaching out with that right foot. Stack it underneath your right knee. We're gonna tuck your tailbone slightly and then think about pulling your right heel to your left knee so it's this opposite action happening. It's gonna create a little bit more pelvic activation, core activation here. So left knee to right heel to left knee, pull towards each other. Staying super tall, we're gonna pretend we're throwing, anybody chop wood? Let's throw some kindling, throw a log of wood over your right shoulder. So you reach down, keep tension between your knee and your heel. Throw wood over your shoulder, maybe wood chops, yeah? A little different. Maybe if you're a soccer player, basketball player, volleyball, whatever. Grab a ball, throw it over your right shoulder. Let's do two more. So tons of tension here. We're reaching down to the left knee area, throwing over our right shoulder. Let's just say that's good on the left side. Try the other side. So stack yourself up, left foot right underneath your left knee. Your body is over top of your right knee. Pull your heel and your knee towards each other. Reach down in front of your right knee. throw that wood over your left shoulder. Yeah, let's do six. Let's pretend that's what we did on the other side. Maybe we did, I don't know. There's three. So if you don't chop wood, do you play sport? Maybe you have a little sibling that you want to throw over your shoulder. I don't know. Something. Throw it over your left shoulder. There we go. We're going to do your rolling patterns and your wood chop things one more time each. Right hand twice. So reach, head lifts, eyes follow. Smell that left armpit. Roll to your tummy. Reach, your hand leads first to get back onto your back. One more time with the right hand. Smell your left armpit. Reach, 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 reach. All the way to your back. There we go. Left hand, your head lifts, eyes follow. Lower body should just flop over. One more time. Don't hold your breath either, it'll make it harder. There we go, number two. One more time. So maybe you're chopping wood. Maybe you stand like this, you chop wood, right? I don't know. Or we throw in the wood over your right shoulder. So reach down towards the left knee, throw it over your right shoulder. Let's do four more. Remember that tension between your front heel, your back knee. Let's say that was six. I think it was six. Who knows? Six on this side, tension. Front heel, pull to your back knee. Reach in front of your right knee, throw it over your left shoulder. Maybe you got like a sandbag, you got a lift over your back, over your shoulder. Right? Anything. Two more. All right. Let's retest. I'm always curious to see if people need stability instead of mobility. Okay, so reach up over your head. Do you feel better with a little bit more stability? Core stability, hip stability. My arms are way straighter than the beginning. Way straighter. Love it. I'm feeling good. I hope you guys are feeling good. It's getting a little gray out here, so let's get it going. Hey, Ty. What's up? Two working sets. 2 6-minute working sets. We have two exercises each set, okay? So within that 6-minute working set, we're increasing the reps by one every time we get back to that exercise. So I'm gonna show you what we're doing, then I'm gonna start the timer. First exercise of the two, right leg, stepping forward to a step back. So it's that half kneeling position that we've built our chops with, right? Step forward, step back. That's one on the right. Then we gotta go one on the left. If either of those two don't feel great, sometimes a step forward doesn't feel good on people's knees. Don't do it, just do your step backs, okay? That's exercise number one. So we gotta do right and left. Then we're coming into a plank. Okay, hands right underneath your shoulders. We are gonna kick your left foot underneath your body to the right. We're gonna tap your right hand to your foot. You can't really see that. Kick your right foot underneath your body, tap it with your left, right? So we are here, and we're gonna increase one rep per side there as well. So we have a step forward, step back. Each leg, we have to increase by one. Then we gotta go into that plank star tap thing. Increase per side by one. First working set. We're ready to go. 6 minutes. If this plank doesn't feel good for you, you can be here, you can do shoulder taps. You can come down to your knees, shoulder taps there. Stay super long through your spine. First working set, you guys. 6 minutes. Go. I can't get this started. So, if you want a challenge, I'm a pretty competitive person. If you can get more reps than me in this 6 minutes, I'll give you a virtual high five. Or if you get more than me in 6 minutes, I'm back in Vancouver this week, and I'll give you a real elbow bump. I don't know. So two on the right. You also might want to pace yourself because it is 6 minutes. Two on the left. If you start doing these plank things and they become like 10 reps a side or something, and you're like, Megan, I can't do this anymore, go back to a shoulder tap. Maybe you put your knees down into that shoulder tap, okay? Listen to your body. And let's just hope it doesn't rain here on us. Three with the right. Three with the left. I hope you guys can hear my music. It's good stuff. Good stuff. Three. Oh, guys, we're just over a minute in. Heart rate will probably get up because we're not really going to stop moving. So that's good. All right, number fours. Feeling good, you guys? Let me know. Two. Four. It's really hard counting and talking. You know, I've done it for 4 months now on this Instagram Live, but it's hard. So like I said, lots of single-legged exercises today. I guess two, but they're both single-leg. So four per side here. Three, three, four, four. What do we think, you guys? We get it up to 10 a side. Competition is to them. Maybe you're trying to beat them. Five. Five. Number sixes. Six aside here. I lost count. I lost count again. Okay. Let's say that's good. Minute and 20 seconds left. Let's finish number sevens. Sevens. seven. Whew, 30 seconds. Let's go. I got four more. 10 seconds, 13, 14, 5 seconds left. Keep moving if you got to. First 6 minutes done right there. Goes by super fast, right? Okay, grab water. We have one more working set. Let me know how you guys are doing. I will show you our next two exercises. Guys, it hasn't rained yet. I'm so excited. Okay. Next two exercises. Number one, lateral lunge to a curtsy. Two different hip motions going on, hip movements. Again, if it doesn't feel good, take one of them out. If you know the lateral doesn't feel good, take the lateral out. Who cares? Do what feels good for you, okay? So lateral, feet come wide. We chop at the hips, like you're pulling your pants down to moon someone, right? If you haven't done that, try it. If you have, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Butt goes back, lateral lunge here. See, my bum is above my knees. And we kick it back, right foot, whoa. Not like that, into a curtsy. So lateral lunge, curtsy. We gotta increase by one each side. Number two, nice and simple. We're gonna get our heart rate up. Jumping jacks. But what we're gonna do is increase by 5 with those jumping jacks, not 1, okay? So a little bit of math, the second round, 6 minutes of work. Jumping jacks don't feel good. You can do lateral steps, maybe just your arms. Just listen to your body today. We got 6 minutes. So, when we're ready to go, lateral lunge, one on the right into a curtsy, one on the right. Switch sides, you don't have to switch directions. Just showing you the movement pattern. There we go, 5 jumping jacks. 5, so 2. Number two, good. Again, you don't have to switch directions. I just want to show you the movement pattern. If that lateral doesn't feel good, take it out. If the curtsy doesn't feel good, take it out. 10 jumping jacks. Nine, 10. Okay, number three. We're 1 minute in. Oh yeah. Three. 15. I'm gonna cross my feet. Ten. 11. 14. 15. All right. This one might get spicier than I thought. Number fours. I think we're gonna beat the rain. Keep that heel down in your lateral lunge, please. Four. Do not put your weight into your toes. Don't do that. Three. And four. 20 jumping jacks. Five.
so good. So number six, right? I hope that's right. Three. Six. Six. All right. Last one. Sit into your heel. 35. Kids, if you are on here, jump. Do it. Three, four, three, five. Oh yeah, number sevens. Maybe it'll be on par with the last set. We did sevens there too. We have one more minute from here. Four. Five. Six. Seven. 45 seconds. We're finishing to the end of these jumping jacks. Six. Seven. 40. We have 20 seconds. We're finishing.
Ten more. Nine. Ten. 6 minutes, 15 seconds. Anybody beat me? Got that competition going on, right? Or am I just by myself? Good job, you guys. My heart rate's up. Anybody beat me on here? Sarah? We finished sevens on both sets. Super good. Well, you're still here with us, so I'm glad you stayed, Sarah. All we have to do is open up. It's 9:58. It's like 30 minutes once we are done stretching. So, just like the world's greatest stretch as we started, right here, we did this at the start. If you want, drop your back knee and pull your chest forward. What is that little thing? Sarah, what is that? Okay, can't tell what an emoji is. Pull your chest forward, then you can reach up. I really like this one. When you exhale, you pull that elbow down. You don't have to do that if you don't want to. Let's do five here. A sloth. Hey, Sunday morning. That's okay, you're allowed. Now you got a half an hour movement in for your day. Hopefully you feel good, feel better than when you woke up. I was super stiff when I woke up. As you guys could tell, my arms were like this, up overhead. I feel way more energized, feel way better. Sunday morning, and it didn't rain. So good. Okay, so other side. Pull your chest forward, maybe you drop that left knee out to the side a little bit more. Nice big reach up. Ooh. Exhale, elbow down. Minutes, you can get your heart rate on, up, sweat on, right? Feeling good. I hope you guys are feeling good. Let's do two more of these. We're breathing. So, 4 months, up north. I drive back to Vancouver tomorrow. Super, super weird. Can't believe I've been home for 4 months. We're gonna do that child's pose that we did at the beginning. Bum back to your heels. As you inhale, pull your body forward. Shoulder check, shoulder check. So you can find me on movement schedule Thursdays and Saturdays now. Any parents out there who want a kid's physical literacy workout, I'm thinking Saturdays after my last class. Can't remember if it's 11 or 11:30. Start time for the kids. If you want it, you have to let me know. I'm not gonna add the class if there's no interest. Please let me know. Let's do one more here. If you like that pec opener, I would suggest doing that. It just feels good for the upper body. Okay, thank you guys so much for joining. Hope you have a wonderful Sunday. Go enjoy some brunch or something. Enjoy your day. See you this week, baby! Crazy!